All right, gents. So this is one of your older audio files. This isn't last week's, but it still applies here. And I am using Adobe Audition. You guys, I don't know if y'all use Audition or if y'all use Logic or Audacity or what have you, but compression, it's still all the same from a fundamental standpoint. There's a lot of different compression tools, but it's still the same from the fundamental levels. What I'm looking at here on the screen now, the green is the actual waveform of the audio that came in. And over here on the right hand side, you have all of the measurements in decibels. So that's your amplitude and how loud it is. Ideally, I found that you can be safe being at the most minus 3 decibels. I typically don't go to minus 3 decibels. I typically hover around minus 6 to minus 9. Seems like that's a good sweet spot for the stuff that I produce, to where it still sounds good from a clarity standpoint and quality standpoint, in addition to it being loud enough. And if someone wants to increase the volume, it'll increase the volume and still have a good quality, rich sound to it. Okay. So let's look at your waveform here. I'm going to zoom in a little bit. Just zoom in on this waveform pretty tight. Okay, so down here is right here where my mouse is. This is a quieter section of it. And if I was to play it back,
they coming, man.
It's just
too many stories that come up.
Dialogue, like which Chapman. Is totally fine. And of course, if I go over here where the waveform gets bigger, this is where it's getting louder, more amplitude. So you see, this is minus 9, and this is minus 3, and this is topping out over here on that minus 3 side. And that's a pretty big gap when you're listening to it in with your earbuds in. So you go from pretty quiet to pretty loud, and it's not like a gradual effect. It's pretty jarring. So zoom in, and the more I'm zooming in, you can see that it's not necessarily stopping. Okay, the way these waveforms, the way these parts of the waveform have a bit of a like a tear showing on it, this one here is pretty much flattened out. So that means it's still going beyond the actual measurement of minus 1 decibel. So that's really loud. And if you look how thick this is and look down here at the bottom at this really, really yellowish color, that shows you that it's really loud in that particular spot. So I'll play back. You got normal dialogue here, and then it gets loud.
For now. I want a chopper now. You're going to let me leave because this is my country.
And even like right here, you see in the bottom right corner, that little meter at the bottom right, it goes up to red where everything else is hovering the yellow and then the green. So that's your indicator. Compression, what compression does is take all of those extra high amplitude and brings it down to a normal listening level and tries to balance it out with everything else in that waveform. And if there's something that's below the regular listener level, it tries to bring it up to balance it all out. Now, the tools inside of Audition, which is probably the same as whatever tool you're using, it's just a compressor tool. Audition, it's got a bunch of different types of compressors. I find just this old school one, this tube modeler, works best for me, just because it's just a simpler interface. All right, so this is the compressor. And the threshold is what you want to say, hey, I don't want anything to go over this number. That's what your threshold is. The output gain right here, you have to have an output gain because as you're compressing down the stuff that's loud, the stuff that's not so loud gets caught up in the compressor, so it's going down even lower. So that's where you tell it, okay, I'm bringing up the stuff that's a little quiet so we can balance it out. And typically anywhere between 3 and 4, you know, 2 and 4 decibels should be good. This ratio, this is just part of the math of the compressor saying anything that's over the threshold, we're going to bring it down by, you know, 2 decibels or whatever. typically stay between 2 decibels and 3 decibels. If you go over that, it starts to sound a little bit like you're talking into a can. So I would just start out for you guys just to do 2:1 or 3:1 at the most. The attack is when the compressor actually kicks in. So as the compressor is listening to your audio file, and when something goes above that peak threshold, the attack is, how fast is it going to kick in? You want that to be pretty quick. And 20 milliseconds is pretty much a standard. So keep it at 20 milliseconds. The release is when you want it to turn off after it's, you know, compressed down to stuff that's too loud. You don't want it to be on too long because it'll make everything that's not in that threshold sound hollow. So ideally about 100 milliseconds is something that is a number that seems to work well for most cases. Now, as I play through this, you'll start to see some little meters move up and down. This here will be the actual meter for the file that's being played. And then this meter over here, it'll start to flash red to let you know, all right, we're compressing it down at this part of the file. So let me zoom in over here. We'll zoom in on some of this audio. And I'm going to set the threshold to... You know I said I like to keep it around 6 to 9 decibels, but if I set it to 6 or 9 decibels, it's still a little bit too loud. So you just need to play around with it. But I'm gonna set it, you know, like 8 right now, just so you can see from a visual standpoint. All right, so we're gonna hit play.
He's out there saying, and they done talked all along, said some of the people that have come out and
see. There's no compression happening because right now we're at minus 12. Our threshold is set to minus 8.
Has supported those folks before.
Okay, so let's move up in this timeline a little bit. Hit play.
Get him out of the spotlight, but he's going to be coming out here.
Don't get me started on this.
All right, and as usual, Fat Man is usually the loud person. So as soon as he spoke, he got loud and went over the 8 decibel threshold. So let's play it back again.
Coming out here.
Don't get me started on this.
And you should have seen this little red mark kick in. It says, all right, I'm trying to compress him now.
Coming out here.
Don't get me started on this.
I'm just saying.
Okay.
I'm just saying.
So now we'll push ahead a little bit.
You know what, Giuliani, that's respectable, dude.
Yo, really?
The other stuff. I know that.
Okay. And that looks fine. So I'll just go ahead and hit apply on this. We'll just say minus 8. Play that back after it processes or whatever. So again, it brought it down, but if you look closely at this stuff, there's still a lot of clipping happening right here. Okay. And that's not good. Nor do we see that the waveform is starting to, you know, sort of get closer to an even waveform across all of the peaks. There's still a lot of dips and valleys and stuff in here. We want to try to get that stuff fairly even out. So that's why I set it to that -8, -9 or whatever, because that's where I typically like my final volume to be. But that's never enough in the compressor. So you're going to have to be a little bit more aggressive. So I'm just going to zoom in a little bit more. And we're going to turn that compressor on again and just readjust it. So compression tube model, and it was set to -8. I'm going to drag that down just by pulling this meter, or I could type it in. I'm going to put it down to about -20 something, -23. So put our playhead right here. We'll start right here with the playhead because it's quiet there. So now it's pretty much going to compress everything. Everything that's over the -23 decibels. All right.
I got to make sure the thing is all where. Because everybody's out here. We cool. We're walking around. Everything is great.
Okay. So it's compressing everything. But it's really going to kick in when it gets to the stuff that's really, really loud. So let's get to a spot that's really, really loud. And you'll see how much more it pulls down.
The animals are coming. Pets.
I think they're already here.
Are not your friend.
They are not.
So yeah, it went below -6.
I'm seeing things happen in the news, and I see some things every day where we are allowing.
Okay. I'm gonna once again, Fat Man Yellow.
Three Mercury Sable outside his house.
Yeah.
Left the dog inside. He came outside. The car is slowly going around in a circle.
In a back. Backing up. Okay.
So that's working pretty good there. I would actually take it down to maybe 24 or so.
In a circle.
And I think that works pretty good. So if I hit apply, and when we look at the waveform, now if we look at this waveform, it looks like everything is getting a little bit closer together from a relationship standpoint. These peaks are, this peak isn't much higher right here. This peak isn't much higher than this peak down here. Okay. So now everything's getting a little bit more normalized. So when the volume goes up in the audio file, the compressor's pushing it down, and I can still hear that someone is speaking louder, just from the way they interject and just from the way they project it into the mic, but my ears don't feel it the way a loud, jarring sound would be. So let's go back here, normal dialogue, hit play.
And she stands up and starts crying and screaming. This would really be the time when you get daddy. Have you done me wrong? Have you? Until she gets out there and cries and brings up pictures and shows how
I don't know if that would work still.
Has been molesting her.
I don't know if that would work still.
On the flag, in the White House, in the Oval Office, and she shows pictures where he has done all these
nasty. Yep, clearly got a little bit more passionate right there, but your ears don't feel a difference. Okay? Go over here to a really loud spot.
Vet says something ain't right. Wait a minute. This ain't no damn cat. This is a goddamn puma.
And see, and laughter is usually louder.
It was a baby puma. She thought she had rescued a cat.
See what I'm saying?
But it brought it down, and it's not hurting ears. But that's the compressor. There's no real like an absolute setting. Compression is something that you have to adjust regardless of the show that you're doing, because sometimes the room is going to sound different, the dialogue is going to sound different, and so your compression settings are going to vary from show to show. But for me, just an ideal, I already know I'm typically going to start somewhere around minus 22 or so, and with 2-to-1 compression, output gain is 4. You can even push that up a little more. Push it up to 5 and apply it. Because again, we want the stuff that's quiet to be brought up just a touch to match the stuff that we compress down. And it still won't sound like super hollow or super artificial. It should still sound normal.
So I guess they kind of hit it and then it ran into a. They open up the car door and the dog jumped out like it wasn't nothing.
So he's yelling.
Yeah, but the dog, because once
it
again.
It doesn't hurt. And then if you guys want to do some equalizer on that, you can. That's all up to you. So if I zoom out on this waveform, now there's no like chopping off at the top. Everything is nice and, you know, little peaks on it. Mostly. Mostly. There's some other stuff I could do to that, but that's not the point of this video. All right. Hope that helps. That's using a compressor. I highly recommend y'all add that, because y'all, neither one of y'all speak at the same amplitude, and it does make a big difference listening. Because if I'm going down the road in the car listening, I'm fighting with the ambient sound of the streets and trying to turn the volume up so I can hear the person that's not speaking as loud as the next person, and then all of a sudden the next person starts speaking, the audio gets too loud for the car or too loud for my earbuds. That's it. Yell if y'all need any help.